Now to Apple's move into artificial intelligence. The company announced it will bring the technology to billions of devices. Janae Norman here with the details. Good morning, Janae.
Good morning, George. So many of these new updates are very cool, I will say personally, but are geared to making using these devices even easier, including incredible updates to Siri. Now, this isn't asking, hey, Siri, what's the weather outside? It means that we will soon have the ability for artificial intelligence to edit the tone of our emails, not that I ever need that, to our liking, and so much more.
This morning, the power of artificial intelligence in your pocket.
Introducing Apple Intelligence, the new personal intelligence system that makes your most personal products even more useful and delightful.
Apple announcing what it says will be game-changing updates, generative AI called Apple Intelligence to be integrated across its devices. The company changing everything from how you write emails to what Siri can do for you.
AI really understanding your habits, where you go to restaurants, which friends are maybe prioritized over others or family members. It's an AI brain now coming to Siri that Apple's introducing.
Take photos, for example. You can use Siri to search your camera roll for certain images or find a specific moment in a video.
You'll be able to say, show me my photos of Stacy in New York wearing her pink coat. And Siri will bring those right up.
You can be more animated, messaging friends with different tap back emojis and Genmojis, which you can create in Apple's new Image Playground. The new AI operating system will also include software that will write and proofread emails and notes, even changing the tone of something you've written.
This is great for making sure your cover letter for that job you're excited for lands perfectly.
Apps will also see upgrades, like math notes on iPads, where you'll be able to solve a problem by just writing down the equation, which may raise some eyebrows.
The concern, especially when it comes to kids around academics, it's going to be a headache for teachers, for administrators.
And Siri is now more in tune to you than ever.
When you talk to Siri, you'll notice it's more deeply integrated into the system experience with this elegant glowing light that wraps around the edge of your screen.
Apple also announcing its partnership with OpenAI, allowing users to do searches on Apple, accessing ChatGPT. CEO Sam Altman saying the partnership is making it easier for people to benefit from what AI can offer.
And Apple's head of software engineering said Apple Intelligence will use but not collect your data. So, okay, what does that all mean? When you ask Siri a question, if it's too complex and requires more processing power, Siri will ask, do you want me to use ChatGPT to do that? And whether it is a photo, a question, or a document, Siri then gives you the answer right there on your phone. It doesn't send you to an external site or anything. And Apple says that none of what you've shared will be saved.
And that's what they're saying is so game-changing about this. It sounds like sci-fi for a lot of people, yeah. And it's going to be really hard to understand this until it actually is a part of phones, which is still not going to happen until later this year. Yeah. But if Siri can deliver on all these things you just laid out, Janae, it is a game-changer to be able to, for example, they showed in the presentation, to be able to say, hey, I want to send this picture from the picnic yesterday to my mom. Yes. And just say that to Siri instead of having to go and search for it or fill out a PDF. They showed filling out a PDF with information from your phone.
From your license.
Because, exactly. So being able to pull that number.
Yes.
Very big change. And it's like having a personal assistant in your pocket, which I get not everyone's comfortable
with. Yes, and it can sound scary. And you talked to Sam Altman about that. He said that it's good that we should all be afraid of this. And you said, are you personally afraid of this? And he said, if I said no, you maybe shouldn't trust me. But there are benefits to, hey, what was that thing my husband sent me the other day? Hopefully Siri can help you remember.
Right, exactly.
One person who's not happy about it, Elon Musk, he's not happy about this development. Are his concerns valid?
Well, so, and he tweeted yesterday, and I want to read the tweet. If Apple integrates OpenAI at the OS level, that's the operating system level, then Apple devices will be banned at my companies. That is an unacceptable security violation. Now, I want to point out a few things. First of all, he's got history with OpenAI. He co-founded the company in 2015, left the board in 2015. 2018, and now he's starting his own competitor company, which just raised $6 billion.
Important context.
There is some context. Yes, Janae, exactly. So there is some context there. And I just want to point out what Apple is saying. Privacy protections are built in for users who access ChatGPT. Their IP addresses are obscured, and OpenAI won't store requests. And they say that in the future, you'll be able to use ChatGPT or other things, too.
Right. So it is getting the benefit of artificial intelligence, but that privacy. That's what Apple says.
Janae, thank you.